Welcome to Kiran's Learner Academy. Dear students, we are over here to discuss the topic of arithmetical problems, which is important for the SSC. Reason being, although it is related to mathematics, but a easier level of the same topics we do in the mathematics, some of the questions are asked even in the reasoning section. So let's see what all topics, questions from which of the topics he asks in the reasoning. So let's see the questions. First question. The age of x is 2/3 of y. And after 6 years, that means x plus 6 is 46. So x at present is of 40 years. So present age of y will be 3 by 2 of 40. That means he is of 60 years. That is option number 3rd. Let's see the next one. A man was 32 years of age when he had his first son. His wife was 35 years of age when his son retained the age of 7 years. The difference in age between the man and the wife. So if we talk about when he had his first son, the man was of 32. So we can say that wife was 35 minus 7. Because his son has attained the age of 7 years. So that will give you 28. So at that time, the man was of 32 and wife was of 28. So the difference will be of 4 years. That is option number 4. My father is 21 years older than me. That means this is you. He is 21 older than me. In 12 years time, his age will be twice of mine. That means f plus 12 is equals to twice of y plus 12. That means y plus 21 plus 12 is equals to 2y plus 12. Y plus 33 is equals to 2y plus 12. So that means 24. So that means y is equals to 9. So he's of, you are now 9 years. Next question. The average age of husband, wife and their child 3 years ago. That means minus 9 upon by 3 is 27. That means husband, wife plus child is equals to 81 plus 9, that is 90. And that of wife and child 5 years ago was 20. That means 50. So what is the present age of husband? All the 3 is 90 and wife is child is 50. So that means husband will be of 40 years. That means option number 1. X is 4 years older than Y, who is twice of Z. X plus Y plus Z is equals to 34. So it is talking about what is the age of x. So if we write that x is y plus 4 plus y by 2 is equal to 34. This is y 4. So 5y by 2 is equal to 30. That means y is equal to 12. If y is 12, then x will be 16. So the option will be the 4th one. Next, if 12 men complete a work in 4 hours, then in how many hours will 15 men will complete the same work? So this is the question based on time and work. So if we say that it's the same work, so the efficiency will be the remain the same. So 12 into 4 will be equals to 15 into question mark. That is the number of hours we need them. Question mark is equals to 12 into 4 upon my 15. So that is equals to 16 upon 5. That is equals to 3 hours and 3 hours and 1 by 5 of an hour. That means 3 hours 12 minutes. That is option number 3. 4 friends ABCD deposits an amount. A deposit twice of C. That means C has divided A by 2. B deposits half of amount of A and D deposit B by 2, that is A by 4. So who would have bought the same amount? That is B and C, option number fourth. Next question. There are some flowers in the basket and every next minute it gets double. At the 30th minute, the basket becomes the full. Then exactly which minute the basket is half full? That means if there are some flowers, so 10th flowers, the next minute it will be 20. Similarly, next minute will be 40, then 80. It is asking like this. And it is saying that in the 30th minute, the basket becomes the full. So exactly before that, if 29th minute is worth half, then only in 30th minute it will become full. That means in 29th minute, it was half. Next, in a group of equal number of cows and herdsmen, the number of legs was 28 less than 4 times the number of heads. So that means if we talk about legs, that will be 4 cows plus 2 herdsmen is equals to 4 times the head of both. That means cows plus herdsmen was 28 less. So it becomes 4c plus 2h is equals to 4c plus 4h minus 28. So it is asking about 2h is equals to 28 and h is equals to 14. That means herdsmen were 14, that is 4th. What is the sum of squares of digits 1 to 9? That means 1 square plus 2 square plus 3 square up to 9 square it is asking about. So for that we have the formula, that is n plus 1, n into n plus 1, 2n plus 1 by 6. This is equals to 9 into 10 into 19 over 6. So it will be 19 into 15. That will give you 285. The option is 4th. Next question. Which of the following equation is correct? So if we apply the Bodmer's rule, so this will give you 6 plus 12, which is not equal to 6. Then if you see this, this is 36 plus 2. 4 plus 8. So this is giving us 12. So the option will be 31. Next, the population of the city doubles every 7 years. In the population, there is 1, 2, 4, 8, 3, by which year population will increase to this. So if we 2009, it was 1, 2, 4, 8, 3. After 7 years, that means 2, 0, 1, 6, 2, 4, 9, 6, 6. Right? Then if we again 7 years, 7 years means 16 plus 7, 23. 49932. That means in 2023 it will become double the number it was asking. So the option will be the second. Next question. X02 multiplied by Y9 should be equals to 15678. That means, so if we look for this, that means 18, 9x. That becomes 2y, 0 and xy. That becomes 8, 2y plus 1, 9x and xy. So that means 2y plus 1 is equal to 7. So 2y is equal to 6, then y is equal to 3. Similarly, 9x should be equal to 6 and xy is equal to 15. So that means we have y is equal to 3, that is option number 1. Similarly, next question, Amar uses a Maruti van and Anthony a racing car from Mumbai to Pune. Maruti van has a speed of 120 km. And the racing car is 210 km/h. After driving for 12 minutes, what is the difference between the two? So they are moving in the same direction. The speed should be subtracted that is 120, into 12 by 60 minutes. This will give you 90 into 12 by 60. So this is 2. That means it is 18 kilometers. The option is second one. Excluding stoppages, the speed of the bus is 54 km per hour, and including stoppages, it is 45 km per hour. For how many minutes does the bus stop per hour? That means it is 54 km per hour and next is for 45 with the stoppage. So the difference between them is 9 km per hour. So it is talking about the minutes. So if we calculate this, this becomes 10 minutes. So the option is next. If four cats can kill four rats in 4 minutes, how many minutes will it take 8 cats to kill 8 rats at the same time period? That is equals to 4. Next, town A and town B were 600 kilometer apart. Joshua left town A for town B and travel at an average speed of 65 kilometers per hour. At the same time, Minan left from town B to for town A. The two of them met 5 hours later. Find the average speed of the Minan. So in this direction, in this case, if we cover like after 5 years they met. So if we talk about Joshua, the 65 into 5. This is the distance he covered in 5. That is 325 kilometers. The rest distance, total distance to be covered is 600, but the 325 is covered by Joshua. So the remaining, that is 275 kilometers, is to be covered by Menin. Then Menin is speed we have to calculate, and time we know 5, that is 275. So the speed will be 275 upon my 5, that will be 5. That is 55 kilometers per hour. That is one. Option number one. Next, an insect is walking in a straight line. It traverses 15 centimeter, covers 15 centimeters in every minute. After every 15 centimeter, it takes a return of 2.5. So net distance covered by him in 1 minute is 12.5 centimeter. And it is talking about 1 minute. This equals to 12.5 centimeter. It is talking about 100 centimeters. 100 centimeter, that will be 1 by 12.5 into 100. So if we, that is equals to 8 minutes. So the option will be the second one. Next, a bus left with some definite number of passengers. At the first stop, the half of the passenger left and 35 boarded. At the second stop, 1/5 of the passengers left and 40 boarded the bus. Then the bus moved with 80 passengers towards its destination without stopping anywhere. How many? Suppose if there were niche, originally it was X. At the first stop, half left out, half left. Then 35 were added. This was the thing when he started from the first stop towards the next stop. Then, of this, 4 by 5 passengers were left and 40 boarded, and it is equal to 80. That means x plus 70 upon 2 into 4 by 5 is equal to 80. This is 22. X plus 70 will give you 200. Sorry, this is 40. 40 left, so 10 will be over here. So it will be 100. So X is equal to 30 passengers. That is option number 2. If the sum of a number and 1/5 of half of that number plus 1/5 of that number is 22/3 more 1/3 of that number. So the number is 7x plus 10 is equal to 22 plus x over 3. 21x is equal to 220 plus 10x. 11x is equals to 2 to 0, x is equals to 20. So the number is 20. There live 80 families in a small spread area. 20% families have cars, 50 of the remaining families have motorbikes. How many families are there which have no vehicles? That means if we calculate 1 by 5 of 80, that means it is 16 families have car. Then remaining is 64 remaining families, and half of that means 32 families have motorbike. So the remaining families, that is 32, will have nothing. That is option number second. Next, if the 35th percent of a number is 12 less than 1 by half of the number, then the 12 is equal to x by 2 minus 7x by 20. That means 3x by 20 is equal to 12. This becomes x is equal to 80. So the option is first one. Next, a father increases pocket money of his son by 20%. If son gets rupees 300 after the increase, then that means 120% of x is 300. That means x is equal to 300 into 10 by 12. So this gives you 250. That is option number 1. Next question. In a given figure, there are 10% students and parents. 10% students and teachers and parents. There are 15% parents and teachers. 35% students and teachers. How many percent are there? Only teachers, only parents. And this is this complete circle of students. That means this is 100%. And the common part is 35%. 45, 55. The remaining will be 45. So 45 are students. So either this or this. Then if we talk about the teachers, so this total will be 100. Then 60 are involved somewhere else. They are students, parents, or something like that. Then remaining will be 40. If we talk about similarly for the parents, that is 15 and 20. That will give you 35. That means 65 are only parents. So the answer will be only teachers 40, then parents is 65, and then 45. So that is option number 2. Next question. A square of side x is inscribed in a circle of radius 4. Then x is equal to, that means x squared plus x square is equal to 8 square. 2x square is equal to 64. X square is equal to 32, and x is equal to 4 root 2. Option number 2nd. Next, in a given perimeter, what is the maximum area? If we are given certain area, if we are given certain perimeter, the maximum area will be covered by the circle. If the ratio of the areas of two squares is 6 is to 1, then what will be the ratio? That means a1 square upon a2 square is equal to 16 upon may 1. That means a1 upon a2 is equal to 4 is to 1. That is the ratio of their perimeter. So the option will be first one. Next, the ratio of two numbers is 3 is to 5 and their LCM is 300. Then one of the numbers will be, one of the numbers you can calculate as 300 upon 3 into 5, that will give us 20. That means 20 into 3 is 60. This is one of the number, and 20 into 5 is 100. So the number is 60. That is third option. Next, the present ages of three friends are in the proportion 6 is to 7 is to 8. 5 years ago, the sum of their ages for 48. Find out the present ages. That means 6x plus 7x plus 8x -15 is equals to 48. 21x is equals to 63. So x is equals to 3. That means 6x will 18, then 21, and then 24. That is option number 2. Next, two horses A and B run at a speed of 3:2 ratio in the first lap. During the second lap, the ratio differs by 4:7. During the third lap, their ratios differ by 8:9. What is the difference in ratio of their speed altogether between the two horses? If we see the ratios of the difference, that is 3:4 plus 8. This is the first horse, and then 2 plus 7 plus 9. So that will give you 15 plus 17. So the difference between the two is 2. That is second option. Next question. The height of the three towers are in the ratio 5:6:7. If a spider takes 15 minutes to climb the smallest tower, how much time will it take to climb the highest one? That means that 5x distance covered by him, 5x distance is covered by him in 15 minutes. Then what about the 7x? Then 15x, 15 over 5x into 7x, that means 21 minutes. So the option is third one. Next, a single discount of 30, 20 and 10% is equal to, so we can say that it is 100 minus, this is the formula, 100 into 70 will be the remaining of the first one, then 80 will be the second one, and 90 will be of the second one. And if we calculate it, it will get us 100 minus, this will be cancelled out, this comes out to be 50.4, that is equals to 49.6. That is option number 1. Next, the price of the article has been reduced by 25%. In order to reduce this, restore the original price, the new price must be increased by. So if you see that if the article is of 100, it has decreased by 25%, that means the current price is 75. So now it has to increase it again by 25, but on the ratio of 75. That means in 200, that means 1/3. 1/3 of percent is 33 whole 1/3. Next question. A, B, C are three numbers such that A divides B and B divides C. Then definitely A will be, then A will divide C. That is option number 2. Next question. An official meeting is attended by 130 departmental employees. Of them, 66 drink tea, 56 coffee, 63 juice, 27 can either this. So let's make a diagram, Venn diagram, in which this is coffee, tea, juice. 5 employee can drink any of the 3, that means 5 will come over here. Then 27 can drink tea or coffee, this is whole is 27, that means 22 will come over here. Next, 25 can drink coffee or tea, coffee or juice, 25, that means 5 is over here, that means it will come 20. Next, 23 can drink juice or tea, 23, that means 5 and 18 over here. Rest it is asking that 66 total drink tea. So this will come out to be 66, they are saying. So this is 45, that means 21 for the tea. Similarly, for coffee they are saying 56, and 56, if we calculate, this is 38 and 5 is 43. This will be remaining with the 63, and this is 23, that means juice is 20. Rest, this is 42, 47, and we are saying that 56 can drink. 47 is this, that means 9. So how many can drink only tea, that is 21? The option is first one. Next, in a school, the bell rung once after each half an hour. The school starts at 8 and closes at 1:30. The bell rang 3 times continuously at the beginning, at the lunch break, that is at 10:30 and 12:30. How many times is the bell rung every day? So if we see this from 8 to 1:30, we have how much time period? That is 5.5 hours. 5.5 hours means that every half an hour it is ringing. So that means 11 times it will run. But it is ringing 3 times at the beginning and at the lunch break. That is at 10 and 10:30. That means 2 plus it will give you 8. That means 19. That will third option. Next is Sonu and his friend Rahul went for shopping. Sonu had 500 with him while Rahul had 240. If Rahul spent X, then Sonu must have spent 2X. So the left money with Rahul is 240 minus X, and with that of Sonu is 500 minus 2X. Sonu has 3 times, that means 500 minus 2x is 3 times of 240 minus x. That means 500 minus 2x is equals to 720 minus 3x. That means x is equals to 220. That means Rahul has spent 220, so Sonu must have spent 440. So the option will be the fourth one. Next question. The ratio of the ages of man and his wife is 4:3. After 4 years, it becomes it. At the time of marriage, it was this. How many years ago they were married? So it means 4x plus 4 upon 3x plus 4 is equals to 9 by 7. So it is 28x plus 28 is equals to 27x plus 36. So x is equals to 8. That means the present age of that man and wife are 32 and 24. And if their time of marriage, that means 32 minus some y, similarly 24 minus y is 5:3. That means 32 into 3 will give you 96 minus 3y is equals to 120 minus 5y. That means 2y is equals to 24. That means y is equals to 12. That means they were married 12 years ago. That is option number 1. So these were some questions we looked for arithmetical problems based on the ages, time and work, and many other topics. So thank you.